Remember when you used to go to the doctor and your health information would be written down in a medical record? With the rise of technology, these charts have moved from hard copy to electronic. Now when you go to the doctor, your information is entered into a computer database known as your electronic health record, or EHR. But what happens to the data after that? Let's make this short and sweet by exploring how chocolate is made, starting with its main ingredient, cacao. The cacao tree is where each cacao pod is picked and represents the EHR database at each network institution, where a patient's health information is collected and stored. Each institution has a system for collecting health information, storing it electronically, and protecting it. On the cacao tree are many pods. An individual pod represents one patient's EHR, essentially their electronic folder. Within each pod are several cacao seeds. Seeds represent a patient's medical history, including all diagnoses, study procedures, lab results, medications and prescriptions, and demographics in a patient's EHR. When you remove the layers of a cacao seed, you find the nib, the innermost part of the seed. In our analogy, this represents specific health data a team is researching. Smooth chocolate liqueur is created by extracting and grinding the nib of each seed. Similarly, patient EHR data used for a research study is extracted and generated into a consistent format at each institution so that all patient data is in a standard format, using standard language. If researchers are studying hypertension, for example, this step ensures that doctors have recorded blood pressure numbers in a consistent format in all patients' EHRs. Chocolate liqueur is next combined with milk and sugar to form chocolate crumb. Once the crumb is formed, there's no way to separate the individual nibs, or in our analogy, patients' EHRs. This makes it impossible to connect health information with a patient's identity before the data is stored and protected behind each network institution's firewall. This step, de-identifying data, is crucial in research using EHR data because it ensures patient confidentiality. Next, the conching process grinds the crumb with more cocoa butter, turning the mixture into silky milk chocolate. Similarly, PaTH network institutions use the Common Data Model, or CDM, to further refine their EHR data to create a consistent format. The CDM organizes data from multiple institutions into a standard structure so that each healthcare system is speaking the same language. This helps researchers avoid having to transform and prepare data for each research question. Now the chocolate mixture is ready to be poured into molds. The chocolate bar itself represents each site's data set that's ready for researchers to analyze so they can answer important questions. Air bubbles are removed when chocolate is poured into the molds, which is similar to how researchers clean up data sets to make sure they're complete and ready to study. Now you're ready to dive into the treat. This represents the point when researchers can dive into data, make connections, and help answer important questions and improve health outcomes. Pretty sweet, huh?